Hey, what's up, besties? It's your girl, E.Michelle, and I'm back with another video. Thank you so much for stopping back by my channel. If this is your very first time, stop what you're doing. Click that subscribe button as well as the notification bell so you don't miss any more of my videos. So today we're going to be... Ooh, that was so ratchet. I'm sorry about that, y'all. I've been sniffling all morning, so I apologize. But today we're going to be doing a collab video with Shay Budgets. She actually decided she was going to try horizontal and join Team Horizontal. So we're going to see how she does. We're using the exact same kit. This is from Print Petticoat Bandit. And I absolutely love this one. I foiled mine. I don't think she foiled hers. So mine may be a little bit different from hers. But let's go through the kit. So we have our full washi and our bottom and top washi, and then some boxes. I'm just gonna go through it because y'all know I'll be tearing up these names. Full boxes, then we have like some script words over here, the bows, and then the bow, what are those called? Like bow checklists. Those are so cute to me. And then our icons are foiled as well. They're rose gold foiled. That is hard to say. Try to say that at home. Rose gold foiled. And then we have our full boxes here with the girls, and then the deco girls down here. I love that in the deco. I just think this kit is just so stinking cute. And then we have our bandit girls down here, and I love that she includes the different skin tones all on one. I just think that is so super cute, and you get all the ones that you're, you know, kind of looking for. And then we have our full boxes with the bow checklists in there, and then some glitter washi here. And up at the top is like some glitter scallops. That's cute too. And then we have our half boxes and quarter boxes. And there's a Netflix binge sticker over here and Girls Night Out. And then we just have some more of the icons and then like the washi strips. And I love, this is one of the pages I love and then I don't utilize enough. But I'm going to try to utilize that in this kit here. So then I wanted to show you guys, I have an obsession slightly with collecting gift cards. So if you guys are looking for something that you're like, ooh, what can I get E.Michelle? I mean, not really, but really for real, if y'all think about that. I collect gift cards. I have no idea why. But anyways, I got these from Starbucks. The girl was so sweet. I was telling her that I collect them. She was like, oh, well, there's some more over here. Have you seen these? And she gave them to me. So in order to, I wanted to find one that like kind of matched what we were doing today. So yeah, this is my pile of ones that I use to cut washi. So that's a tool that we need to have over there. And we're going to be using the Erin Condren. This is one of her markers that she has. And what is that on there? I'm going to be using the fine tip of that one, and it's just a marker. And then I found this washi here, and I got this from one. This one here is from Wonton and a Million, and then these three are, of course, Simply Gilded. So I did not get in on the fall presale. I was so like, oh, I don't know, I'll just wait until she puts them back in the shop. Y'all, she ain't put them back in the shop, and I'm feeling some type of way. So I had to make me up some fall washi, and I refuse to go in that group and buy any more. So I'm hoping she comes out with some additional ones. So if you guys are interested in seeing how I put together my spread, then stay tuned. Alright, so I put down the washi on the side and I went ahead and did that off camera. It was a little bit of a struggle and I was like, y'all need to see all this because it was just a lot. So that is the Wonton and a Million washi that I put on the side, and it's kind of not sticking the way I want it to stick. I don't know, it's just like lifting a little bit. And of course, I always have struggle season with the washi on the bottom. And I like using the washi on the bottom, even though it covers up a lot, a lot of Thursday. But I don't know, maybe I'll work on cutting it down going forward. That might be an option. So I'm just taking a piece of the washi and I decided to cut it to fill in that little gap because that was going to annoy my entire soul. So I wanted to make sure I could cover that in, and it kind of worked perfectly. So you'll see me often just kind of going back over that washi and trying to put it, you know, make it lay down flat. So I'm taking one of the full boxes over on the side to cover up that black and white. I do love the neutral planner so much. I just think it's amazing, but there are some spots I'm like, I wish this wasn't here. So I added that full box with the girl down at the bottom, and I realized
I probably could have cut the washi down for real, because it definitely I'm laughing, like, I just covered up a whole lot of stuff. So anyways, I put down the deco up at the top because I love adding that little extra deco up there. Now I'm adding in my date covers, which they are foiled. Like, how cute is that? And I should have went ahead and put down my date dot covers but I definitely didn't. I don't know, I didn't have my tweezers by or something. I don't think I was thinking that one all the way through, but now I'm going back in. I'm just adding those date dots that are foiled as well. Like, I just love this kit so much, and I love Print Petticoat Bandits kits because you really can't go wrong with our kits. And then now that they're foiled, like, oh, they're just absolutely amazing. So I'm just taking now my full boxes and kind of sticking those strategically throughout the page. I haven't quite figured out still, like, how I want to lay full boxes yet, and I think I said I need to lay the full boxes and then lay the date dots, and that might help me, but I never remember to do that when I'm recording or actually doing my plan with me. It just never happens. So now I'm taking some of the page flags and I'm putting them over on the side and kind of making like a little banner with them. I thought this would be a lot easier than trying to cut my washi and do all this. So, and then it didn't like extend far down. It just kind of gave me a little nice banner, and I like that. And I put down the weekend word script there, and that is foiled as well. And then I just put a remember sticker in one of the bow clips, which I love. I think those are just so adorable. And then I decided, I was like, it needs a girl over here, so I added the girl sticker as well over there to the corner. Up at the top right now you can not see because I'm out of frame, but I'm putting down like a birthday sticker over there. And now I'm just going into my Monday, and what I'm doing is just kind of doing the deco portion of it before I write things down, because I want to see how things fit, because I've usually already have my plans pre-planned out on the side, so it gives me a visual of where I need to place things. And I love using icons. You guys know I'm a functional planner, and I like looking at things that will, you know, be functional. So I set down those desks. I like using those. You'll see how I write things down at the end, but I just thought that was cute. So maybe I need some like desk stickers by themselves. So I just put down that payday script and then one of the flags. Now I'm just doing the habit trackers over there in that corner. And I added YouTube and Instagram over there. I'm not really sure what I'm going to do with that little box in between, but I added the bow just to kind of make it not look so spacious and crazy. Now I'm just going in, adding another bow and an appointment label. I wasn't quite sure what I was doing there. I just wanted to make sure I noted that I had a doctor's appointment on Tuesday, so I do not forget that, because that is important. Those are my dermatology appointments that I have once every 6 weeks, and I'm hoping that my face is doing so much better. I found the girl icons and I was like, I need to use those. So I put that down over that page flag over there on the side. Oops, sorry. And then I put down one of the girls with the coffee, just kind of hung over because I have some presentations and things I have to do this week that I normally do not do, and I want to make sure that I get them done. Like, I normally don't plan my work stuff in this planner, but because I know that this is like a really important presentation, I know I'll probably be working from home doing some of that presentation, which it's the end of the year presentation that we have to do, that corporate comes down and we all talk about it and everybody has a portion, and yeah, it's just a lot. And I really don't like those. Okay, I know this is gonna sound really weird. I don't really like talking in front of people. And I guess because it's like business wise and I'm like, what do you want me to say about my job? Like, it's talking about me. I don't know if that's weird. Like, it's different from talking about my plans or talking about what I do on my YouTube channel. It's like literally talking about what I've done at work and trying to reiterate that to people. So I don't know, I'm just kind of weird. Let me know what you guys think about that. Like, do you guys have issues with like talking about stuff, doing presentations and stuff at work? I guess because I don't really have to do them anymore, and so to have one that I do once a year is just, you know, causes me a lot of anxiety. So anyways, now I am writing in my plans, and those doodles that you've seen are from Starlight Paper. Let me make sure I say that right, because I'll tear that up. I think it's Starlight Paper Studio. And you guys can find her on Etsy. She also has a YouTube channel that I love. I love how she does her Playing With Me's. I just think it's just so cute. So I had to make sure I supported her now that her shop is back open. So make sure you guys go support her. She hand draws all of her stickers. So yeah, I think you guys will really, really like it. The coffee cup and that iPad doodle are from her shop. So I'm just writing in my plans for Monday. I know I need to do a lot on Monday, that's why I kind of left a lot of room there. And I got the TV stickers, and I just have too many shows to write down, but it just lets me know that I do have a show to watch on that night. So that's why I put that down there. And then you see how I'm writing underneath the desk just the things that I have to get done, because I'll be sitting at my office doing that stuff. And then I just wrote in that it was Zip's birthday on Friday. Zip is Austin's auntie on his dad's side, and they do a lot for Austin, so I want to make sure that I call her my little sister too. So I want to make sure that I remembered that it was her birthday. And then I'm just writing down random stuff that has to get done.
All right, you guys, so here is my completed spread, not my completed plans. I basically just planned for everything that I could, and then I'll fill in as the week goes on. I'm loving how this turned out. It is just so stinking cute. Look at this. Look at the foil. Oh, I love doing this. I love foiling, but it does take some time. Like, I wanted to put foil in my shop, but whew. All right, so here's everything. I love this. Make sure you guys check out Print Petticoat Bandit, and make sure you guys go check out Shay's channel to see what she came up with using this same kit. And I think, let me show you guys all of my extras. I'm trying to decide if I'm just gonna give this away or try to use it in my other planner. I'm wondering if I should use this in my mini for next week. I think I may try to use that. I don't know. But here are all the stickers that I had left. I tried to use a lot of my little girl stickers because I love those. I have a lot of icons left over. Of course, you guys know I always have this sheet left over. I never use that. I just, not in this horizontal. It just doesn't look good for me. That's just a personal preference. And then here's this sheet. There's still some bows over here. This is a foiled sheet. There's this sheet here. It has a habit tracker. That might be pretty good. And a couple of the washi there. Some of the icons left in the washi strips. And then the half boxes and quarter boxes. This is going to make a pretty good, like, side kit if somebody wanted to use it. So I don't know. I may include this in my end of the whatever I call those. Y'all know what I'm talking about. When I give them away, I may include those in there, or I might try to use this in my mini. I haven't decided yet. So anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. I will catch you guys in my next video. Head over to Shay's channel. Make sure you guys watch her video. Tell her I sent you over there, and let me know what you guys think about being team horizontal. I will catch you guys in my next video. Mwah! KK, bye!